Hey everybody, thank you again for tuning in to Soul Food from the Kitchen Table. Glad to be with you all today, and got an interesting topic today, and just what's going on around the world, in our world. We have a lot of protests, and some have gotten out of hand, and I want to share a Bible scripture with us today, Proverbs 29, verse number 18. And it says, where there's no vision, the people perish. Where there is no vision, the people perish. And I want to stop right there. There's a little more to that scripture. It goes on to say, but he that keepeth the law, happy is he. But where there's no vision, the people perish. And what we've witnessed over the past several days, and the family of George Floyd, we send our condolences, friends and family of his, and we've all seen the video or parts of it. I saw a little bit of it and just, I didn't want to see it again. But there's a looming problem in our society. Those of you who follow me for some time now, the first thing we need to get out of the way is there's only one race, the human race. And when you start causing division, you cause problems. We can look at the founding of America, and one of the reasons there's what we call politics is the reason for Democrat, Republican, I know you had a Tea Party and some independents, but the reason for a split from the political heads is that to keep the people from being one. In other words, the government knows that if everybody come together in the world, in the United States, they know if everybody come together, it's gonna have to be government of the people, for the people, by the people. So to keep the people divided, you come up with different political parties, you come up with different religious sectors, you come up with different belief systems and different societies among the people, because if the people come together and get on one accord, there's going to be massive unity, and the 1% that actually run the whole world globally won't be empowered anymore. That's the first thing I want to get out of the way. And so we have to get ourselves in condition. The Bible says it this way, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. And what renewing of your mind consists of is getting you to come into a new way of thinking subconsciously. Let's use this for an example. Back in late December, early January, you may say you're going to eat better. You may say you're going to join a gym. You're going to do save money. And a new thing takes serious focus daily throughout the day, because we all know by mid-January, early February, most people who say they were going on a diet change their mind. They slip back into their normal, because in your subconscious, you have to really work on changing it, because it's the habit forming. If you've ever been to a good party in your life and you had a few drinks and maybe a few too many, but you made it home safely, you just didn't remember the whole trip. That was your subconscious guiding you home. If you've been on your cell phone, you riding down the road, you're going to work or to a grocery store or to visit a loved one, and you looked up and you were there. Like, God, dog, I don't even know going past such and such and such. It's because your subconscious guided you there. Because your subconscious is already programmed to keep you the same. So what you have to do is work on focusing on the new thing you want to do and changing your subconscious, putting your subconscious in agreement with your conscious. Now I'm teaching you subconscious and conscious with the hopes and dreams that you'll at least inbox and ask me more about it. Do your own research. The God mind in you is the conscious mind, also connected to the subconscious mind, which is the lower self. Okay? And the Bible says when they were in one place with one accord, we keep looking at it in the physical, but in the spiritual realm, if you're in one place inside of your individual body and your conscious and subconscious come into agreement, there's nothing you can't achieve. There's nothing you can't do. Because now, through the Spirit of God, through the Spirit that empowers you, through the power that is in you, through the dominion that you have as a human being, you can achieve anything you focus on. That's why when you focus on bad things, that's all you see. If you see the world is not a good place to live, you're going to be attracted to things that give you the reality that you're speaking and the way you're thinking. As a man, as a human, thinketh in his or her heart, so is he or she. As a human being, thinketh in their heart. So if you think everybody is racist, that's all you're going to find. Somebody's mind could be on something else, and they pass right by you in a grocery store and don't speak because they were thinking about something else at their attention, and you say they're racist because they didn't speak. And when all in all reality, you're thinking about racism, so that's what you see. What we focus on, what we draw. And when we don't have the proper vision moving forward, is where I'm going with this, we perish. The Bible also says we perish for lack of knowledge. Those things we don't know. So when we don't know something, we make an error. It's not that we fail, but now we have to reset or reprogram our thought pattern. Or have a change of outlook. And with what we're seeing going on in America right now, is a lot of outrage. The cop was wrong. In my book, if I was the prosecutor, I'd give all four of them the death penalty and be done with it. And that would be over with. Period, point blank. I mean, that was totally wrong. And what I need people to understand, a lot of the rioting, the looting that you see, there's a group called Antifa. They get paid to go start riots, to start looting. So we have to be aware of that, because on your television, the media, whether it's CNN, Fox, whoever you listen to, they tell lies to your vision. In other words, it's called television programming. They program you to see what they want you to see. They want you to have a certain narrative. And so whoever tells the story gives you their story. That's why it's called history. It is their perspective, getting you to be programmed to believe and see things the way that they see it. So when the media says everybody's rioting, there are several videos floating around on social media right now of a police in Minnesota going to that first auto zone, the first building that went up, busting the windows out. And a guy holding a pizza in his hand said, "Man, why are you doing this?" The guy had the same mask on as the cops had. They had people in Atlanta from Antifa spray painting Black Lives Matter on the Starbucks. Two Caucasian young ladies, they had an accent light. And then when I looked up Antifa, a lot of those people come from foreign countries. So they didn't have time to fly these people over here to insinuate riots. And when a person is angry and they see somebody bust a window and that person said, "Come on, let's do it," they're already charged with anger, because when you're angered or you're instilled with fear, you can't think properly. That's why we have to have self-control. And this is something that we have got to do a better job with for our youth. Because when they get angry, they express themselves. And most of the time we're seeing now, it's going to be an outbreak. So in Washington, D.C., a video, four gentlemen in what looked like an undercover police SUV, a black SUV, parked on the street. The guy jumps out to go start busting windows and starting a fire. He had all his equipment with him. So the guy filming this asked him who he worked for. Who was he with? He said, "I just saw you get out of that white truck. I mean, the black truck." And the guy said, "I can't tell you that." Then the guy mumbled that he worked for CNN. So the guy the video recording goes back to the black truck where the other gentlemen are sitting, and they didn't have a comment. So in the midst, that's why we have to have self-control, because in the midst of a disagreement, things can spiral out of hand like it already has. And of course, we do have an understanding that some of the people whose businesses are being burnt, it's going to benefit them through the insurance money, because due to the lockdown, they lost a lot of money anyway. So it's actually going to become a blessing to those business owners. But if you're not thinking on that perspective, if you're scared with fear, or if you're angry and you just see what the news is reporting, you think a bunch of animals are on the loose in the United States of America. And another reason we have to have self-control, because at some point, the National Guard and the police are going to start killing. The warning was already given out in code to be on standby to get people in position. Now the next warning is going to be a straight out martial law act. Things that are already in place. So we have to be careful and have a good understanding. There are two communities that I'm going to share with you briefly, and not going to be long today. The Jewish community. I love the family values and morals that they have. They control their banking system because they empower each other and they invest in each other. Strong a child, whether it's a boy or girl, when they become a young teenager or a young adult, they celebrate that point in their life. They celebrate the gradually, but they want to make sure they instill family values and morals, love and respect, not only for yourself, but for others in our community. And they take care of their community. Nobody's going to be poor in their community. Nobody's going to have lack. They pass businesses around. They pass money around because collectively they save money together to empower one another. They say the Holocaust will never happen again. In fact, some of my connections in New York, when the coronavirus got out of hand and they had the stay-at-home order in New York, in certain areas of prominent Jewish communities, when they would have 200 or 300 people at a funeral, when there was a stay-at-home order already in force, the elders would walk up to the police when they would come to try to tell them to go home, and they would tell the police, "We dare you to disrespect this funeral. You leave now." Because when you are empowered within and you have a community filled with love, compassion, forgiveness, you got power. I've said many times before, I don't have any problem with people doing what they want to do. But as far as I'm concerned, 1968 ended all the marches where they didn't have power then. Because the same community I just mentioned benefited from the civil rights movement. But again, we perish for lack of knowledge. We're misled. So we keep trying to revisit the past and thinking it's going to help us in the future. But economic empowerment is the only way. Economic empowerment and unity. And as a nation, we have times in this nation where we come together. No matter what color you are, when there's a national disaster, the world comes together. And we're at that point now where everybody needs to come together. We don't need to become filled with outrage and hatred. And I understand every aspect of it. I understand all of it. But we have to have self-control, and we have to be empowered. Because if we had self-control, we could already be enforcing or focusing on what's going to bless us the next 50 years as this country moves forward. Because the powers that be have already made plans for the next 50 years. Over 600 billionaires in the world during the whole coronavirus pandemic have continued to increase their wealth when everybody else's finances have gone down. See, when things are planned and you have things in order, that's why it's called order. Even when it appears to be a pandemic, you can still prosper. Again, the Bible says, my people are destroyed. It didn't say my race. God said my people. There's only one race, and God made the human race. The most dominant of all God's creation is the human race. There's only one. And when people go to divine you by how you look, there's nothing wrong with identifying. God didn't make minorities. He made a majority of empowered human beings made in his image and likeness in the spiritual realm where all your power is. So as we pray, because a lot of this outrage again, not only from the death of George Floyd, but from people having to stay at home. You don't tell healthy people to stay at home. And let me share with you why I'm talking about to stay at home. There are over, it is estimated in 2020, the year we're in now, that there are over 330 million people living in the United States of America. 331 million people. So there's not a pandemic. There's an awareness to a virus. But there is an awareness that needs to be to suicide. There's an awareness that needs to be made to domestic violence. There's an awareness that needs to be made to car accidents, to cancer, to heart attacks, to strokes. And the majority of what I just named, if we would just be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind, could change it all. Your mental health is important. Your overall health is important. That's where you become wealthy at first. Overall health. If you don't have your health, I don't care if you got $1 trillion. You're not going to live to enjoy the luxuries of life. But if you become healthy, you're just as happy and you're just as prosperous as the richest person in the world. But if we don't know that, if we're steered in the direction of fast food restaurants, if we're steered in the direction of food that's not even real, if we're steered in the direction of getting on medical medicines, which at the end of every one you see on the commercial, they start talking real fast at the end because there's 1,000 side effects up to and including death. But when we rely on what somebody else is telling us, instead of relying on what our own bodies are telling us. Our bodies are made to heal themselves. I see people all the time talking about what happened with Dr. Sebi. They want to know about the conspiracy theory. Don't worry about the conspiracy theory. He left you all the information. Never no way. Our hearts go out to his family if he was indeed murdered, and certainly on the transition of him because he was just becoming popular, but his material is still here. All the herbs, the natural healing herbs, are still here in this earthen vessel. So he's absent physically, but in the spiritual realm, and his lessons are still here for us to prosper and take advantage of. The help is still here. The messenger is not physically here, but you can go to YouTube given day, still out. So I just wanted to share those few things. Let's continue to think. The Bible says, where there's no vision, the people perish. What God showed me for the year 2020, the year of vision and crazy faith. To start seeing our future and go get it. To see our future, see how, picture how we want our lives to be and go get it. Write it down. Write the vision. Make it plain. And strive every day to to get closer and closer toward your goal. Remember, what you focus on expands. So when you have a vision, if you focus on it, it's going to become so big till it becomes you, and then it is already your reality. So everything we want in life, let's focus on it. Closer relationship with God, a better life spiritually, and I'm talking about growing. I ain't talking about no Sunday come to fussing message. I'm talking about a message that will empower you, uplift, inspire you to reach for those things that God has shown you that you can obtain in life. Because it doesn't matter how old you are, when God gives you the gift called today and the gift of vision and the gift of going after it by faith, that's what I mean by crazy faith. Year 2020, the year of vision and crazy faith, to go after things like you've never gone after them before and be happy in doing it, and watch how God constantly empowers you. He gives you the roadmap. All you got to do is move one foot in front of the other one. If you need more wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, I'm a witness. Ask him for it. And he'll open up venues. He'll send the right people in your life to pour wisdom, knowledge, and understanding into you. Whatever you ask God for, he'll give it to you. You just have to keep focused on what you want. What is the vision? Because it's God empowering you with the righteous thing to do. That's why we always talk about purpose, vision, and destiny. A personal purpose. Your purpose may be to have a family, have a good job, give your family the best life, be here to see your great-great-grandkids. And instill values and morals in them as well as you did the first generation. Go for it. Go for it. Go for whatever it is God is showing you. We all have our own individual gifts. We all have our own talent. When God shows it to you, go for it. It does not matter. Nothing else matters. Because God is going to have you doing things that you enjoy. And sometimes you may be in a temporary place. You may have a business idea, but you're working a job that you hate right now. Or you might not be so pleased, but you're filled with gratitude, and you're going to use that until you get to the next level. Or you may be on a job that you're going to retire from, and you just enjoy a hobby on the side, serving the community which you live in, or serving the world. And that gives you great pleasure. Whatever it is, it's on the inside of you. And we have to stay focused on the vision God is showing us. We have to stay focused on our purpose, because there are going to be a lot of distractions. There are going to be a lot of things going on. When they first came out about the coronavirus early March, I started telling people, just be aware of all your surroundings. And more importantly, get some sea moss in your life. Get some turmeric in your life. You know, those healthy vitamins and minerals to strengthen your immune system. Focus on wellness. If you can get rich on wellness by having a strong, healthy body, our bodies are made to empower us, to give us energy to perform or utilize the gift that God gave us on a daily basis. So I pray this has been encouraging today to help empower us, uplift us, inspire us to be that all that God created us to be and to do all that God created and empowered us to do. Again, everybody that's protesting, be safe. Protest or not be safe, be aware of your surroundings. I've been saying this, some point I tell you why I'm asking you to be aware of your surroundings. And quit looking level, look up. I ain't talking about no UFO, but just look around you. And at some point, when it's time, I'll tell you why I asked you to do that. I see things going around us all the time, changing the world, and nobody's paying attention. The world is going to change, we must change. That's why we need vision. to look forward. Nothing wrong with taking a moment to look back where you came from, but keep your mind focused on the future. When I played football, the coach would say, keep your eye on the ball. Lose focus of the ball, you lose focus of the world. Keep focus. Keep that vision on your purpose in life, using the gift that God gave you. And God gonna lay the blueprint out. You run into a problem, okay, pause for a minute. Like in sports, when things don't go as planned, we call timeout. But we got to regroup. Because defensively, they stopping us. Or we on defense, offensively, they done something we didn't know they were going to do. So we had to make adjustments. So in life, you have to make adjustments. And I pray this has been a blessing to you all today. Continue to pray for our nation. But I'm reminded as I come to a close now, what President John F. Kennedy said, ask not what you can do, what your country can do for you, but ask yourself, what can I do for my country? What can I do to make a change? The late Michael Jackson said he was starting with the man in the mirror, the human in the mirror. And I leave you with that today. And we see a bright future. We see a future where people are going to love each other what race they are. We see a future where police commanders and police chiefs, the heads of police unions, are going to tell their officers, our job is not to kill anybody. Our job is to serve and protect all mankind. Do it with love and compassion. And whenever you meet a hostile situation, call high authorities before proceeding. We speak that over police all across the United States, that those in charge will have those words to say to all of their officers. And I know there are some good officers right now who are quiet, who don't want to be a disruption on their jobs. So they don't want to say anything. But we speak now that as you're being quiet, that you seek a high authority in you, and that's the God in you that lives in you to empower you from the inside on the right actions, the right service, the right obligation, and more importantly, the right love to share in this world. And to all the citizens of the world, especially right here in the United States, let's let our hearts be filled with love, compassion, and forgiveness. Let love lead the way. Let's stand in unity. Let's hold politicians accountable. And based upon the responses now from politicians, some of them don't need to get back in office. But I just warn you, don't fall for the game. Because a lot of you have been trained and programmed to be Democrats. Some have been trained and programmed to be Republicans. But behind closed doors, some of them swapping money with each other every day to lead people astray. But you have to hold people accountable. Let's be more informative. Let's have more knowledge. Let's move in the right direction. And again, we'll speak unity, because one day it's going to be unity. My final words, whenever a seed is planted, the seed grows in dark places. Several breakthroughs happen. In order to have a breakthrough, it has to hurt. And one of the final breakthroughs is when a seed sprouts upwardly and breaks through the soil, when it breaks through the earth, growing towards the sun. And as Americans, as we grow toward the sun, as we empower ourselves, as we go on our daily journeys, this way, that way. Some knowing what's going on, some unknowingly. We speak the word of love. Because with love, this world will move forward. This nation will move forward. But where there's hate, there's always going to be destruction. So again, we speak love. I pray everybody have a blessed day today. I'm going to end right there. That was my prayer. Unity. Unity. And when there ain't no love, ain't going to be no unity. So I speak everybody, let's love one another. Let's come together and make this world a good place where people can have fun together, love one another. I miss the old days when police would ride through the neighborhood and get out and play football with the kids in the park, play baseball with the kids in the park, have events, and some do, with the children of the neighborhood. That made they're raising up kids not to hate police. And that police is showing the kids that, hey, we don't hate y'all. So we got to start some more programs to number one, get the bad ones off the force. And the ones that love their community, let them be able to show it. I don't know how it's going to happen. I don't know when it's going to happen. I'm just speaking that it does happen. That this world, while the world watches the United States, the most powerful country in the whole wide world, they shouldn't have to see us divided. So again, I call for unity. I call for peace and love. And I speak as some of these cities that have been burned, as they rebuild. We'll have a new way of thinking. Thinking about loving each other first, not killing each other first. Think about compassion, not knowing what a person may be going through, so I shouldn't rush to judgment. And forgiveness. Forgiving the past. Holding those accountable for what they do today so that we all can live to get to a better tomorrow. With that being said, thank y'all for joining in to Soul Food from the Kitchen Table. Please share this video. And remember, not only is the best day yet to come,